Students, I am Ms. Maushmi Sengupta, your chemistry teacher. Today, we will take up the first chapter. Matter and its composition. What is matter? Anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. Some examples of matter are water, air, wood, sugar, cotton, etc. Now, there are three states of matter. One is solid, another one is liquid, and the third one is gaseous state. Now, what is a solid? It is that state of matter that occupies a definite volume and has definite shape. What is liquid? It is that state of matter that occupies a definite volume and has no definite shape. Now, what is a gas? It is that state of matter which neither occupies definite volume nor has a definite shape. As for example, if we take water, we know that it exists in three states. So, water can exist as ice, which is the solid state of water. Now, water can exist in liquid form as water, and it can exist in gaseous state as steam. Coming to the next page, what is the properties of solid, liquid and gas? Difference between solid, liquid and gas based on first property is shape. Now, solids have a definite shape, liquids have no definite shape, whereas gases, they also do not have a definite shape. Coming to volume, solids have definite volume, liquids have definite volume, whereas gases do not have definite volume. Coming to flow characteristics, solids cannot flow. Liquids flow from higher level to lower level, whereas gases can flow in all directions. Coming to texture, that is appearance. Solids are hard, they are not flexible. Liquids are flexible, gases are flexible. Compressibility, solids cannot be compressed. Liquids can be compressed to a little extent, whereas gases, they can be compressed easily. Next, strength of intermolecular force. What is intermolecular force? The force of attraction between the two molecules. Now, in case of solids, intermolecular force is very strong, whereas in liquids, it's moderately strong, whereas in gases, it is negligible. Coming to intermolecular space. What is intermolecular space? The space between the molecules. In case of solids, the intermolecular space is very little. In case of liquids, it's intermediate, whereas in gases, it is large. Next, coming to position of particles. In solids, the particles are fixed. In liquids, they can move to the neighboring spaces, whereas in gases, they can move freely in all directions. Now, next, coming to the topic, that is matter has mass and occupies space. That is, first we will discuss about the first state of matter, that is solid. That is, solid has mass and it occupies space. So, how to know that solid occupies space? With the help of an experiment, we have to show. So, first, to show that solid occupies space, take a bowl half filled with water. Mark the level of water. Put pebbles into it. You will notice rise in the level of water. This shows that the pebbles or solid occupies space. Now, next, coming to the experiment to prove that solid has mass. So, first we'll take a bowl containing water. Next, we'll take a bowl containing pebbles and water. We will see that after weighing both the bowls, we see that the bowl having pebbles is heavier. So, it proves that the solid or pebbles has weight or mass. Next, coming to the next state of matter, that is liquid. Liquid occupies space and has mass. Take a bowl and fill it with water. This we have to prove that liquid occupies space. Keep pouring water in it even after it is completely filled. You will notice that extra water flows out of the bowl. This is because water had occupied all the space in the bowl. Next, coming to the experiment to prove that liquid has mass. Take an empty bowl and a bowl filled with water and place them in a weighing machine. We will see that the pan having bowl with water tilts, showing that water or liquid has mass. Next, to prove that gas occupies space and has mass. So, first gas occupies space. For that, take a balloon, fill air in it. It inflates because air inside it has occupied space. Now, see the arrangement which is given over here. So, when we do this arrangement, we see that the balloon which is inflated, that side, that meter scale, it tilts, showing that gas has mass. Next, let us come to the composition of matter. So, here we must know what is atom, what is molecule. Now, atom is the smallest unit of matter that exhibits all the properties of matter. But, atom cannot exist independently. Whereas molecules, if we have to define, it is the smallest unit of matter having independent existence and it also has all the properties of matter. So, matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms. Atoms combine to form molecules. But if difference between atom and molecule is asked, difference is atom cannot exist independently, whereas molecules can exist independently. Now, coming to the next page, that is the exercise. The oral questions we'll discuss first, that is, name a material that can exist as solid, liquid and gas. So, the answer is water. Which of the three states, solid, liquid or gas, can be compressed easily? So, the answer is gas. Actually, both liquids and gases can be compressed, but easily, more easily is gas. So, the answer will be gas. Which form of matter can flow easily? Gas. How are particles arranged in solids, liquids and gases? In solids, the particles are fixed. In liquids, the particles can move little, whereas in gases, the particles can move freely in all directions.